Alright everybody, welcome, oh big leg spike, welcome back to another episode of Back to the Future. So what do I do now? I have no idea. Yeah, I should have thought of that. Okay.
What the hell is that? What?
Seriously, how gullible is
it? Sorry, I thought I saw a tarantula.
Okay. So do I need to go outside or something? Or is it something here? I'm guessing I have to go outside. Okay, let's go.
What?
I was just thinking about the future. All that talk about Edna's grandfather made me realize something.
Please let it be something about lightning.
Life can be short. Sometimes brutally so. So why not seize the day and grab your happiness while you can?
I'm not sure I like where this is going.
I was saving this for next Valentine's Day, but why should I? I know what I want.
Emmet, no.
I'm gonna ask Edna to marry me. Right now.
No.
Oh, right, right. I'll wait until tonight at the expo. It'll be much more romantic that way. Just think. By this time tomorrow, Edna and I will be engaged and will be the toast of the scientific community. And I owe it all to you.
You're welcome.
Still the same stuff? Yeah.
Hey, Emmet, I've got to go out for a while.
I thought Edna sent you to make sure I wasn't getting distracted.
Oh, you'll be fine.
Great loading. Right, yeah. Okay, you can stop loading now. You can actually load it. Yeah, thank you. He should not be doing that right now. Like, on grass, really? Like, I'm pretty sure you would face plant. I've done it before. Don't do it, Marty! You're an idiot! Okay, where are we? Need something about the past.
Hi, Trix.
Oh, hiya, kiddo. Say, wouldn't it be easiest if I just march up to that Strickland dame and give her a smack in the puss?
Well, it would be fun to watch, but it wouldn't get her to break up with my friend Emmet.
Oh.
Not all of them.
Right, so apparently you talk to her no matter what. I want to see what this does.
Times may be hard in Hill Valley, but our present worries fade into insignificance when we ponder our Pleistocene past. Is the wolf knocking at your door? Be glad he's not a Tyrannosaurus, king of the ancient lizards. And if you find yourself drowning in debt, well, you could be drowning in something a whole lot stickier, like the Hill Valley tar pits. This peek into the distant past is brought to you by Lamont's House of Ermine, reminding you fur is forever.
So, okay, I got to the right place then. Guess somewhere here?
That doesn't need cleaning. Fur's donated by Lamont's House of Ermine. At least they're going to a good cause. They're stuck tight in this tar. It's a good thing I did this before Emmett's 12-hour time limit, where the cleanser might have dissolved the fur. Let's slip out of those furs, shall we?
Okay, what does this want me to do with it now?
Thank you.
Okay. Let me go. Let me go! Cool. The controls in this game, man, they're impossible.
Hey, Doc. I mean, Mr. Sagan.
Excuse me a moment, Miss Strickland. I've got her neutralized for the moment. How's the plan proceeding on your end?
About that gizmo you've got hooked up to the DeLorean?
The chronometric analyzer?
Yeah, what am I supposed to look for again?
A signal that it's done evaluating the time circuits. The analysis can take a while. Be sure to let me know when the light turns green, and I'll take her out for another test run.
I swiped this from Emmett's, your lab. It's
anti-stick, anti-stain formula. I remember it well. I had high hopes for that concoction, until I discovered that it decays into a cloth-shredding enzyme after 12 hours.
That's what your younger self said. Good news. I think Trixie's gonna go along with my scheme.
Pursue whatever strategies you like, but please don't tell me the details.
Okay, I need to make some stuff happen here.
Doc said to tell him when the light on his diagnostic thingy went green. Hey, the light's green. That means Doc could take the DeLorean out again.
Seriously. Let me actually control him.
I need to talk to you.
Excuse me, my dear. Yes?
About that gizmo you've got hooked up to the DeLorean?
The chronometric analyzer?
Yeah. The light's gone green.
Wonderful. If the systems check out, I should be able to take it for another test run. I've got to run a short errand, Miss Strickland. I suggest you think about what I've been saying.
Oh, I will.
Thank you, Watch. I should really turn this off sometime. I believe I can do that right now. If I remember how to do the controls on this.
When did you land this time?
9 hours and 37 minutes ago.
Ouch.
Frankly, it started to get a little difficult to avoid running into myself. Still, the time jump yielded some interesting new data on the flux field. I'll run some more tests and we'll see what we find.
Never mind, I can't be bothered to figure out some stuff. What did you just say? I wasn't listening. Oh, right. Damn it.
It'll be safe in there.
Oh, come on. I can't go around there.
Excuse
me. Sagan?
Much obliged, Miss Strickland.
I wasn't listening.
Yes?
Yeah, come on.
About that...
The chronometric...
Yeah.
Oh, come on. Am I supposed to look at it every time?
Nope. No green light yet.
Oh. So I have to wait. Oh, come on.
Hey, the light's green.
Hey. Just like that. Just like that. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Like a bus there.
Call me... Edna.
I'm sorry to desert you again.
Yes, well, you've left me with plenty to think about.
By the look of things...
7 hours. I'm this close to identifying the problem. Guess I better crank up the old chronometric analyzer once more.
I guess the boss hole thing is done. Not inventory. This thing. Okay, DeLorean.
Nope. No green light yet. Nope. 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 Nope.
Do I take it out and then put it back in?
Doc's trip aged the formula a few hours. Not enough to turn it to acid, though.
I have no idea what this is for. I'm barely following the storyline. Okay, now.
Nope. No green light. Nope. Nope. Nope.
What about a small walk?
Nope. Nope. Nope.
Seriously?
Nope. 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 Nope.
Nope.
Nope. No.
Bigger walk? Maybe. Maybe she's changing.
I wonder how Doc's doing with the DeLorean.
Okay.
Hey, the light's green.
That's a very fast analyzer.
Hey, Carl.
I'm sorry.
Call me.
That face looks like he's constipated. And he's just.
Your chronometer's like gone green again.
He's like.
Time for another test run.
And there's like a bad joke and something.
Strickland.
Go. Oh, I shall God. Await your return.
Any luck this time?
Depends what you mean by luck. My arrival time was off again.
By how much?
8 hours this time. Gave me the chance to take in 3 showings of Frankenstein. Good movie. A bit implausible from a scientific perspective, but I can see how my younger self would have been mesmerized.
What about the DeLorean?
Oh, yes. I did get one critical piece of information. The chromium elements in my circuits became unstable during the temporal shift. I should replace them with titanium.
Great!
Now, unfortunately, titanium won't become commercially available till the Kroll process is perfected in 9 years.
9 years?
But there may be another solution. I'm going to fire up the chronometric analyzer again. Then, while I'm installing it, you can... Uh-oh. Where did it go?
The lab!
You better get down there before she makes the situation impossible. I'll tend to the DeLorean.
Age to perfection.
It just happens that keyboard drives by every time. Idiots.
Oh my!
You know, I thought you were coming down here to keep Emmet focused on his invention.
Oh, she is. But she's generously scheduled brief canoodling breaks every 45 minutes to keep my mind fresh.
Time's up, dear. Let's get back to work.
Shall we?
Now, Mr. Crockett, what can I do for you?
Can I talk to Emmet? It's kind of important.
It'll have to wait until later. Emmett's got a lot to do before the expo opens. Isn't that right, darling?
You know it, Schnookums.
Schnookums?
You can talk to him later.
Mr. Sagan says he needs to talk to you back at the high school.
He does? Whatever for?
That is old by like half a year now.
He says he wants to give you an interview about his invention.
One of those tedious cars of the future? That can wait, invention.
He wants to...
That's yesterday's news.
He says he's...
He does he? Well, I'm not sure anyone cares about that old story anymore. But I suppose I'd spare a few minutes in the service of solving a crime. Will you be all right without me, sweetheart?
It'll be tough, but I think I'll muddle through.
Try to keep him focused. He's so easily distracted.
Don't I wish?
Okay, what do we do now? No not hints. Not the alignment meter.
Hmm.
There it is. I've been looking all over for my portable anti-stick anti-stain formula. Where'd you find it?
Out by the trash.
That's strange. I haven't been out there for hours. Oh well.
Are you gonna spray your jacket? It's looking a little dusty.
Not until it's really dirty. This cleanser doesn't grow on trees, you know. Well, some of the ingredients grow on trees, but the rest are synthesized polycarbonate
really
detergent
dirty?
Blends.
I can do that. I'll wait until you're at the expo to show Edna what a suit-destroying slob you can be. Now all I have to do is set up Edna to think that Emmett's fooling around on her, and everything will be ready to go.
What? Okay, I did not understand that. Trixie plans to be jealous required by a phony diamond. Some furs and a big picture of image. Where? I don't know where it is.
Hey, could we watch Frankenstein on this?
Sorry, Sonny, but I need this projector to trigger positive and negative visual stimuli for my mental alignment tests. Besides, a movie like Frankenstein should really be watched on a big screen, don't you think?
No. Oh my god, I hate this so much sometimes.
Hmm. Must have run out of cards. This button only works while the mind map test is active.
Well, where can I get a photo of him? Why am I even... Okay, where could it be? Seriously, I can't see anything. Is this it? Oh.
What's this?
It's the placard we'll be putting in front of our booth at the expo.
The scientist that caught Kid Tannen?
A small exaggeration, but Edna says it'll attract investors. What do you think of the picture?
You look a little... constipated.
What? Edna said I looked intense.
Yeah, intensely focused on taking it.
I get the picture. I'll have to find a better one. Unfortunately, there's a lot to choose from.
Heavy.
Extremely. Mother has been rather obsessive about photographically cataloging my life.
Hey, Emmett, I've got an idea.
What?
Why don't I take your photo album over to Edna so she can pick out your new picture?
That's a great idea. She's got a better eye for these things than I do anyway. Thanks, pal.
Don't mention it.
Okay, let's go. Ooh, lag spike. Don't ride on grass! Oh my god. Physics!
Marty!
Doc! What's all the hustle and bustle?
It's almost time for the opening ceremony.
Holy jeez, I better work fast. I think I got it all worked out. When it all comes together, Edna will think you're the worst guy in town. I just need a couple more pieces.
Well, don't go to too much trouble.
What do you mean? Oh! You got the time circuits fixed.
Not exactly. You see, I've been mulling things over, and... in the timeline you're from,
the right timeline.
Yes, yes. I've got a wife.
A great wife. Clara, and kids, and a dog, and a bitchin' time train, and...
And Edna? How does her story turn out? How does she end up?
Oh, well, Edna ends up...
I wouldn't say it's best not to know.
She's doing great. She's got a full life, lots of friends, always busy.
She's got a fellow?
Sure, lots of them.
Lots of them? She's a tramp?
No. What I meant to say was...
Let's start over. How does Edna end up?
You're not really supposed to know these things in advance. It's bad luck.
But you told me how my story turns out.
Yeah, but...
And it's not as if I'll be in a position to do anything about it once my younger counterpart's destiny has shifted. I imagine I'll be folded into the new timeline, and I'll probably lose all memory of the old one.
Maybe.
So tell me, just to satisfy my curiosity, what's going to become of Edna?
Well, Marty's memory have been destroyed of the previous timeline because he's now in the new one? Great logic, game!
To be honest, she ends up kinda sad.
Sad?
She lives with some cats in a dinky little apartment, and she spends most of her time yelling out her window at people, and collecting newspapers, and living in the past.
I see. Perhaps we've been going about this problem the wrong way. Do we really have to completely obliterate my timeline so we can restore yours?
Doc?
Maybe we could have the best of both worlds. I could be with Edna, but it could be a little bit, you know, more healthy.
Can you hear yourself? Do you know what you're saying? Let me remind you. It was her influence that led you to take over Hill Valley and turn it into this nightmare state.
Come now. It wasn't as bad as all that. The crime rate was low, and the uniforms were nice.
I don't believe this!
All I'm saying is, let's stop and take a breath. This elaborate plan to derail my younger self's love life, is the short-term misery worth the long-term gain? Maybe we can find a third way. One where everybody wins. What do you think?
No. I'm sorry, Doc. I can't go along with what you're saying. You don't belong with Edna.
So you're determined to break us up, in spite of my stated wishes?
Basically, yeah.
Then there's nothing left to say.
Where are you going?
Why should it matter to you? Aren't you planning on overriding me?
Well, right now you can go back to the future and mess with Marty and stuff like that. So now... Yeah. But anyway, I think this is a good time to end the episode. The next one will mess with Edna and her love life and make her sad and miserable and basically mess up her whole life, so pretty much what she deserves. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you all in the next one. Bye bye.